has now re-emerged in Colombo and suburbs, I should say. This fear was there for some time among the Tamil people in this area of the country. In fact, we Civil Monitoring Commission had documented and reported at least 125 incidents of abductions in Colombo in 2007 alone. And there were some incidents in January too. But anyway, at the beginning of this year, it went down. But now, since the 12th of this month, within last 1 week, we have had at least 9 incidents reported to us. So, I should bring a peculiar situation which has arisen here, because in Deivala, north of south of Colombo, in an area called Kaudana, there were two Tamils living there. On the 12th night, certain persons, armed persons who had arrived there in white van, had forcibly taken those two persons to an unknown location. So the one of the sister of one of the victim had gone to the police station, Deivala police station, and made a complaint on 13th morning, I should say. And on the 17th Sunday morning, I, as the member of parliament, made an inquiry with the police, and police honestly told me that they are conducting investigations and searching for those missing persons, and they confirmed me that there had been complaints of missing persons. But the same police called me by midday the same day and told me that they have come to know that these two persons have been kept at the CID office for investigation on certain other issue. But what has come out of this issue is that police has no coordination within its own branches. Now, this country has been divided, if I can remember very well, into 401 police station areas. Every police station has an area under its authority. And besides, police has certain special branches like CID, TID, Narcotics Bureau, and Road Bureau, certain other things. Like Army also has its own intelligence. But now what has come to light is that these special branches act on their own randomly. And also when they go to arrest a person or investigation, to conduct investigation, they go without any intimidation to the police of the area, without informing the police. And also they go in, they don't go in the civil, uniform, with uniforms for certain identification. And they also don't go in their official vehicles, but instead they use white color vans. So this police is systematically creating unnecessary fear psyche among the Tamil community living here. So what has happened is, now when such things are created systematically by the police itself, the government itself, the defense ministry itself, the underworld elements, the normal criminals also come up in collusion or cooperation with certain elements in the security forces. They come and pick up Tamil people randomly and take them for their own purposes, and extortion of money and so-called kappams are all occur in this city. And now a popular cafe in Vellavatta is owned by one Mr. Chellaya, I think Mysore cafe. He has been taken a few days before from his residence in Vellavatta, and he had been kept for 3 or 4 days and had been released in somewhere in Vattala early mornings of 16th, I should say. And similarly, another two persons living in Jambata street, that is Kottayena, Colombo 13, had been picked up by the same white van armed men, and after 3 days they had been released. Lately, one person, youngster by the name of Surya Kumar, I should say, had been picked up very close to the grandpa's police, that is Koska Sandhya. He had been taken, he is still missing. Another person who hails from Puakpiti, Avisavella, who had come to Deivala for some purposes, had been also picked up, and after 3 days he had been released. So I believe these people who had been taken away have been released after payment of kappam or ransom money or extortion. So who is responsible for this situation? Because the police is systematically creating. Who is stopping this police from using accepted civilized manner in when they conduct an arrest or investigation? They should always go and speak to the police of the area, and accompanying the area police official, they can visit the residence or business place or anywhere and arrest the person. Police, if they wanted to arrest a person, conduct investigation, we are prepared to cooperate, because that is what we want, because we want the rule of law in this country, this area. So what police does is that they go certain areas go they go on their own without informing the area police and create systematically create. So I suspect that police systematically creating this fear among Tamil community in this area, so that they in cooperation with certain other anti-social criminals, they are abducting, taking away Tamil citizens of this country and extorting money. That is what is happening here. So I hold the defense ministry and this government and IGP responsible for all this situation. So you see, they are answerable to this. As a member of parliament for Colombo district and leader of Western People's Front and convener of Civil Mountain Commission, I am telling with all the responsibility.